What's up, Safemoon Army? It's Safemoon Mark here, and there were a lot of people who wanted me to extend my reflection video into discussing the burn specifically, and project how many tokens are likely to be burned in the future. I reference my reflection explained video frequently, so I recommend watching that before continuing with this video. Follow my Twitter to enroll in my many Safemoon giveaways. Super easy to sign up, all you have to do is just follow my Twitter and be subscribed here for a chance to win Safemoon weekly. So for those of you who remember the equation we derived in my reflections video, we defined reflections as being volume multiplied by the number of Safemoon you own divided by 20 quadrillion. Again, this output is the value in US dollars of your daily reflections. As I mentioned before, the burn wallet is a holder, and the tokens that are burned are simply the burn wallet's share of these reflections. So to calculate how much of a given volume is burned, we use the same equation. Now, by replacing reflections with burned, we can see that burned equals volume times the number of coins in the burn wallet divided by 20 quadrillion. Now, this is nice, but remember, this answer is in USD, which we don't care about when evaluating the burn wallet. We only care about how many Safemoon are burned specifically. So we need to divide this answer by the price of Safemoon, or just squeeze the price into the denominator. But as many of you pointed out, these are only good for daily reflections, since the number of coins in the burn wallet grows, and as such, so should our reflections, daily. What we are lacking here is the aspect of compounding interest, because that is basically what this is. Our Safemoon is compounding at a rate over time. However, this rate is based on the volume of Safemoon and isn't fixed like traditional bank accounts. So, we can pull in the equation for compounding interest and relate it to our Safemoon tokenomics to be able to accurately predict where the burn wallet will be in the future. If any of you recall from high school, even if you don't, I'll tell you, the equation for compounding interest can be calculated as follows. The new balance is equal to your previous balance multiplied by 1 plus the rate divided by n raised to the nt, where n is the number of times your amount compounds per unit t. And we are evaluating T in days, so N would be the number of transactions that occur per day. But we're going to be using 24-hour volume in our equation, so N becomes 1. So our equation for our compounding burn then becomes new burn equals the current burn times 1 plus rate raised to the T. Great. But what the hell is rate? Rate will be the rate at which we gain tokens, and this value must be represented as a percentage of our current tokens. This may seem confusing, but we have already solved for this. It is our daily burn equation from earlier. The rate at which we gain new tokens per day is the output of the daily burn equation, divided by the number of tokens in the burn wallet. Okay, from here we get this messy equation, that rate is equal to the volume times the number of tokens in the burn wallet, divided by 20 quadrillion times price, and then we have to divide this entire answer by the number of tokens in the burn wallet again. Well, what happens here? The number of tokens in the burn wallet cancels out, leaving us with a rate that only relies on volume and price. Now we see that rate is equal to volume divided by 20 quadrillion multiplied by price. Let's substitute this back into our compound interest equation to see that the new burn is equal to the current burn times 1 plus volume divided by, in parentheses, 20 quadrillion times price. All of that raised to the number of days that we will be evaluating this equation for. So if we're doing a month, days would be 30. If we were trying to see the answer in a year, days would be 365. We now have a fully functional equation to model how the burn will compound over the next few years or months or however long you want to look. Feel free to manipulate this equation and isolate variables. It'll give you a lot of insight into how Safemoon works at a core level. But that is out of the scope for this video, so I'll just continue with the burn. Now, a couple of you who also have math degrees are probably saying to yourself, but the volume and price are not constant, you cannot evaluate them as such. And you are right, but by using averages and compounding interest, we can get an incredibly accurate result without needing to break brains. But for my math lovers out there, part 3 is coming soon where I evaluate the burn using differential equations, calculus, and my own modeling software to draw way more accurate conclusions about price, volume, and burn. Okay, now we have our fancy pants equation, but evaluating the burn becomes more complicated now since we have two variables for account for instead of just one, both volume and now price. This is where I realized that we actually want the price of Safemoon to stay low over the next couple months. As long as the price stays low, we could burn to as low as 100 trillion coins this year. which means one penny by the end of the year is not as crazy as I thought if things actually played out perfectly. These figures are based on the volume increasing, which I believe full-heartedly will happen once SafeMoon is used not only as a currency, but as a way to cover transaction fees across their wallet, exchange, games, Gambia, and their crypto debit card. All these use cases will drive the volume into the billions, which will give some interesting results when we plug them into our equation in a minute. Okay, now this is important. Let's say the price stays where it is now, around 0.000005, and we see volumes close to $1 billion per day once all the catalysts come to pass. Our compounding interest equation tells us the Burn wallet will have burnt 15.87 quadrillion tokens. Now, before you close the video and say, this guy doesn't know what the hell he's talking about, there's only 580 trillion tokens left, just step back and think about this with me. Our burn equation tells us that $1 billion of volume at this price burns 4 trillion 200 billion tokens per day. When that compounds, we would burn through the entire supply of SafeMoon within 100 days. Okay, so something is not right here. Clearly, I made some mistake, right? No, this is correct. This means that there is no way we can have volume in the billions while SafeMoon is still at this price. What will happen is, once the volume picks up into the billions and trillions of tokens are burnt per day, the price is going to skyrocket to all new all-time highs that we have never seen before. Why? Because it has to. The burn wallet will be burning tokens too quickly. There will be way, 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 way more demand than supply, and the price will need to go up until we see more reasonable figures. Even if we plug in 1 billion per day when the price is 0.00001, that's still over 2 quadrillion burnt. That price is still not high enough. If we are going to sustain even $1 billion of daily volume, our price needs to rise as high as at least 0.00009, or 18x what it is right now. Personally, I believe SafeMoon will see volumes in the tens of billions, and the math says if volume picks up, the price must increase, because it is impossible to burn through quadrillions of tokens when there aren't that many. Okay, enough hypotheticals. SafeMoon has seen $587 million before as its highest volume, and lately it has been around the $50 million mark. Where could the burn wallet reasonably be in 3 years? Well, let's assume the worst case. Let's assume the exchange, the debit card, everything barely raised the volume at all. Maybe it'll raise it up to $75 million. If we keep our price of 0.00005, our equation says in 3 years, the burn wallet will own 955 trillion tokens, leaving 45 trillion left. Even if we do not gain market cap at all and our valuation for SafeMoon stays the same, our price would be 0.00009, or again, 18 times higher than it is right now. Even if we do not grow at all as a community or a company, just from a low daily volume, we will see the supply shrink incredibly low if the price stays at these low levels. What that means is the price can't stay at these low levels. Once the price picks up, the equation says it will take tens of years to burn them all, even at super high volumes. But this is reasonable. At this point, we won't even care anymore because everyone watching this video will have 100x their money. Now, I'd spend hours going through different price, volume scenarios for you guys, but you all have this equation now and have access to a calculator. But if you are lazy and you enjoy math, my part 3 analysis will have a computer doing all of the hard work for us, and we can analyze millions of scenarios per minute, opposed to me spending 10 minutes to get through a couple. All of the cards are saying the price of SafeMoon is destined to go up. Right now, the price is too low to support volumes of even $1 billion. So when the volume does reach that point, the price will have no option other than to go straight up to compensate. But even if the price does not go straight up right away, that is still beneficial to us because we will be stacking up tokens as reflections, and we will burn down to under 100 trillion in record speed. I have invested most of my money into SafeMoon, as these numbers cannot lie, and eventually the rest of the world will realize it too. However, this is not financial advice, just mathematical analysis. I hope this video helped. I hope it gave you a new perspective on SafeMoon, burn, and math in general. If it did, please like and subscribe, and more content's coming soon.